My name is Laura Lavandera, as you just said, and I am here to present our paper called New Technologies Applied to the Development of the Risk Prevention Competency in Engineering Students. We come from the Polytechnic School of Zamora, from the University of Salamanca. Our framework is the higher education area, which aims to train students to become active participants in their own learning process. This is because in the future, students will need certain skills so they can update their knowledge and adapt to new situations once they join the labor market. To accomplish this, we have transformed the traditional practical class, which should help to improve students' experiences in the classroom and make it easier for them to learn. We propose the use of mobile technology to motivate the students. The second aspect that we are currently working on involves making it easier for students to access information quickly and simply, so that they can anticipate possible lab risks and prevent them. We consider that if they can become familiarized with both the environment and the materials and instruments they will be using, they will be more aware of the possible risk and will follow the guidelines to prevent them. We have drawn a series of more visual materials with a much more practical content, and they should find them easier to assimilate and more useful. The information will be made available to students days before the practical session begins to help them become familiarized. As I have said, we have concentrated on preparing the pre-laboratory sessions with the students to make them aware of the risks they might encounter and how to proceed with the ARIs. To do that, we have designed a practical guide that the students must work on before starting the practice sessions. The guide includes these three aspects that we intend to work with the students: the cards providing information about the regions with which the students will be working, the machinery involved in the practice sessions and its proper use, and information about the risk points and safety elements of the laboratory in which the practice sessions will take place and how to identify them and locate them physically. The guide includes not only an explanation of the practical session, but also four other elements: quick response codes, enriched images, 3D images, and risk maps. This is to provide a comprehensive roadmap for the students while in the lab. We start with the quick response code. These codes are similar to barcodes, and they may contain different kinds of information. One of the greatest advantages is that they provide immediate access to the information. This allows students to participate in the classroom and to access different kinds of information when they need it. In order to read them, students only require a mobile phone with internet access and the appropriate software. Their function in the guide focuses on the safe use of laboratory reagents. We have three types of code for each of the reagents. The black code contains safety notions of the reagent in a text format. The blue code contains a link that will facilitate access to a complete safety file of the reagent in HTML format. And finally, the red code allows the students to download the complete safety file of the reagent in PDF. For the rich images, we have selected the Augmentative Research application. This application can be downloaded for free and is available on the usual download portals. It is an image tool recognition that allows the association of additional digital content with selected images. Each marker is associated with a card. By using the Augmentative Research application, students can access this information, which we have used in this case to include additional explanation, videos explaining use of the machine, for example, and links to websites to consult extra information related to the instrument in the image. 3D images allow students to interact with a visual representation of the actual object. In the guide, we use these images to represent the machines that the students will be using. The aim for this is to them to become familiar with these elements in the pre-laboratory stages, so that they can recognize the possible risk elements or safety mechanisms of every machine. To produce the 3D models, we use an educational version of SketchUp. In order to visualize the scene, you need to download the Augmentative Viewer application in the device and download the scene on it. Safety maps can be defined as any informative instrument with means of descriptive information. A suitable markers allows the analysis of risk in a certain area. In this case, many students have never access to these labs before, and therefore they lack the ability to fail. We want them to be able to recognize all points of interest in the lab: points of risk, points of evacuation, and points with safety elements. To develop the map, we follow four stages. The first stage is the cognoscitive stage. In this stage, we analyze the risk factors before students enter the laboratory so we can program preventive action. In our case, we assess the risk points and safety elements of the food technology laboratory where the sessions will be held. Then we have the analytical stage. In this stage, we establish and program the interventions to be performed, taking into account the analysis of the first stage. With this information, we design two maps. One with the risks present in the workplace, and another one with the safety elements of the lab. Third, we have the intervention stage. During this stage, the intervention plan design are put into practice. In our case, we work on the information shown on both maps with the students before starting the practical session. In the assessment stage, well, during the fourth stage, the results of our intervention will be checked. At the end of the practice period, the teacher will be able to check whether the students were using all the resources provided and were acquiring the skills for working with the maps. During the practical sessions, the structure will be first one theoretical session with the to review the practical guide with the students, each of the elements of the guide will be explained in detail. Before the practical session starts, the work they will have to carry out and the machinery they will have to use will be explained to them, and they will also be reminded of the information at their disposal in the practical guide and how to access it. And finally, the teacher will take part merely as an observer and will let the students organize their work in the lab. To obtain information about the students' participation and to assess the experiment, we will use a satisfaction questionnaire and two objective tests to evaluate the knowledge of the students before and after the experiment. The objective test will have two aims: to discern the previous level of knowledge of the students and to obtain an initial measure of the level of preparation in the concepts presented. The different test items can be grouped in two thematic blocks: identification of risk and first aid. The pretest will be applied on the first day of class, and the post-test will be applied through Moodle once classes have ended. To measure student satisfaction, we have drafted a questionnaire with the aim of determining not only the satisfaction of the students with the experiment, but also how they work. With this questionnaire, the aim is to gather information about the following dimensions: personal work methodology of the students, the extent of use of the different elements presented in the guide, the perception of the students about the methodology used, a student's perception of the prevention of risk in the laboratory, general satisfaction with the experience, and evaluation of the elements contained in the guide according to its usefulness. Regarding the general satisfaction test, our aim is to check whether for the students the experience has been positive and it has helped them in their learning process. We would like to thank the University of Salamanca and the Fundación Memoria de Samuel Solórzano of the University of Salamanca, whose financing made this experiment possible. Thank you so much for your attention.